Well, I'm pulling into the knife gig for Thursday morning. You can see it's pumpkin season. Halloween. Look at all them pumpkins. They're just setting them up. You wait till tomorrow to get them all out here. They got, look, they got pallets and pallets and pallets of pumpkins. Stand by. Well, I'm all set up. Thursday. I don't know what Thursday is going to bring, but we'll have to wait and see. I bought this cleaver. This is a nice, heavy cleaver. Look how thick it is. At the thrift store the other day, made in China. $3.99 I paid for it. But it's nice. But it's made by Harris Teeter Cutlery. I didn't know Harris Teeter had their own line. They had a whole box full of knives. A complete set of these. Knives and all. But I didn't want any knives. But I like that cleaver. I'm going to sharpen that up today. And I got the axe that Denny found. That Fiskar axe. I'm going to clean that up and sharpen it today. And then I got that serrated knife that Doc Beaver found. Sharpen that up today. Get some of that anodization off of that aluminum handle. Okay. Right now I'm going to get an egg sandwich. Stand by for the Virginia Beach Farmers Market on Thursday. Beautiful day in the neighborhood. The land of Nada was bleak yesterday for the guys who went down at Denny and Doc Beaver. And Big John. Big John had a better day than the rest of them. He went really far south. And I think Denny's going to the bay today. I don't know about Beaver. I'll let you know more as that progresses. See you later. Well, we initially got all the salt tarnish off of the handle. It cleaned up relatively good with the coarse wheel. And when I get it home, I have that big buffer at home. I'll buff it up and get it immaculately shining like brand spanking new stainless. Where, of course, it's aluminum. And I haven't sharpened the knife yet, but I'm getting ready to do that now. Stand by 1 second. As you can see, when John found it in the bay, it was in relatively good shape. It's not overly dull by any means for a serrated knife. See, it cuts pretty good. Right out of the sea. You see how it does after we sharpen it up. Daggers aren't supposed to be too sharp. They just use for sticking. Japanese Gerber. Harris Teeter.
carbon fiber. I mean, carbon steel. Fisco.
Like I said, that's the initial polishing on this Colton Course buffing wheel I've got. But it's got it in relatively really good shape. Doesn't need anything else. I just want to see how I get on my big buffer when I get home. I finished sharpening it. You know, it was already sharp. But it's somewhat sharper. My old serrated knife found in the Chesapeake Bay. No, I think John found this in the ocean. Hell, I don't remember where he found it at. Somewhere right there. She's pretty sharp.
Sharp to start with. It's just a shade sharper now. Polished up good. The radiant knife. Okay, it's 1:30. I just had those two knives in the one pickup. I'm mumbling. Everybody's going treasure hunting and I'm sitting here mumbling. Hope they find something so I can go tomorrow with hopes of finding some yellow. Stand by.
Well, I put it on the big buffer, and all it did was bring out a little texture. Still shiny, but the salt put a lot of, you know, stuff in the aluminum handle. If you remember that Benchmade automatic knife I found several months ago, what it did to it. But this has never been in there that long. I guess I could grind all that little rough spots out, but I like it like it is. Now this thing is bad right here. That's at 1850. That's what they call turtle speed. Here's rabbit speed.
$3,450.
And that baby will polish up some stuff. But it's extremely, extremely dangerous. If you're not careful, it'll throw the knives clear over there on the beach from here. Not that I've ever done it, but I can tell by the speed that it goes, it would be terrible taquito. Okay, I'm going to cut this grass. And if I have enough daylight, I rode down and looked at the beach. The tide's pretty low. I may be able to get in a quick spin down at the beach, but I don't know. We'll have to see how it goes. Stand by.